welcome along to GkNexus TV. I'm joined today by a very happy Liverpool first team goalkeeping coach after last night's 3-0 victory over Man City in the first leg of the Champions League. It's Mr. John Achterberg. How are you, John?
I'm good, thank you.
There's no other place to start, man. Last night, how did you feel the game went?
Yeah, we obviously played well the first half, and we took most chances we got, and second half, obviously, we didn't play too much football and defended more and got the result over the line, really, and didn't concede, which was good to have clean sheets as a goalie coach, no?
Exactly. So, obviously, in Champions League format, the clean sheet is very, very important. So, how do you think Carrick performed last night?
Yeah, he's not been overly tested on shot stopping, but he looked confident to come to take a ball over the top and playing out and smother a few balls. Playing out was pretty good, decisive in what he had to do. Made on the offside goal the block on the 1v1, so he done pretty well what he had to do.
So the reason why I joined you today is we've obviously been talking for a while, we keep in touch, and it's great to see that what you're doing here at Liverpool. One guy I want to talk about is Jurgen Klopp. What is it like working under Mr. Klopp? What does he do differently to other managers that you've worked with before?
Yeah, he's very energetic in and around the place, and he's talking to everyone, if it's the girls in the kitchen or the groundsman. Everyone is the same, and he drives everyone on to improve and be better, and that's what he does with the players as well. As you can see on the sideline, he's really passionate, and they have a good clear vision with Selko and Pete, the two other assistants, and it's working really well.
And another man that I want to talk about is very much the man of the season this year for Liverpool. Unfortunately, he went off injured last night, Mo Salah. What is he like to face in training as a goalkeeper?
Yeah, he has unbelievable skills. No, he's like if he has the ball glued on his feet, he turns and turns away very quick, and yeah, if you want to jump in, he turns the other way quick again, so he frees himself all the time. And yeah, it's very simple for me. There can only be one player of the year, really. As you can see yesterday again, he had one tricky moment on the sideline with De Bruyne and I think it was Walker, and he skipped around him if they were not there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, if you have a player like that in your team, it's unbelievable, no? We had a few in the past years. Suarez was unbelievable. Yeah. Coutinho was a good player, and yeah, Mane doing well. To be fair, yesterday the whole team, Arnold right back was unbelievable good. So as a team, we played really well. And that is also because the manager motivate the players really well every game to give everything.
So talking about just one last thing on the outfield players, you mentioned a few good players there. Who's the best finisher you've seen at the club to have faced your goalkeepers in training?
As you can see, Salah is a good finisher, but Coutinho had an unbelievable finish with and Suarez. I named them really already. Over the time I've been here, they are hunger for scoring goals, if you like, and yeah, that is an attribute you have to have.
So maybe a lot of the viewers right now might not know a lot about you when you played professionally. You played professionally as a goalkeeper for over 400 games. Mm. So the question I'd like to ask you is there any experiences or methods that you've took with you from playing into coaching?
Playing experience, no. I've played basically in Holland in the highest level a few games, and then came to the Championship in England. So you learn the physical side, the way things work in the game, and you can help the goalies with that. And that's what you do. You talk from your own experience. You know what is needed in some games, and dealing with pressure and stuff like that. So you talk about that to them as well.
So when you're preparing for an opponent, whether it be during the week or on a Saturday, is your goalkeeping program specific to your opponent for that week?
That's about correct. Yeah. Mm. Yeah, we have analyses today. We have analyses for the next game, and you look at the analyzing game, what's happening in the game, and then basically straight after that we train. And in my mind, I make the session then what will happen in the game to prepare the goalies mentally, and tell them already on the field what why we do it and how we do it, and to get them in the right thinking and the right manner for the game.
So that could be long balls played into the box or cutbacks played into the box, things like
exactly
that.
Exactly, that's what you try, and that's where you base the training on, next to the speed reactions, to be ready to make saves and all that stuff. So so if that's gonna be if there's a day good in the air for corners, then you do close range speed reactions dealing, and we do the same movement from the corner. What the goalkeeper do when he steps out to come for the cross, he can't get that drop back in and then make reaction saves, things like that, and make sure that he's in the right angle with his body shape so he can cut the near post and also still do a lot on the far post. So it's a lot thinking behind. Well, you're used to that and you've always been working on that and thinking like that. So
one of the questions we had sitting from our followers, and you maybe covered it slightly there, but he was asking, how do you keep your sessions fresh throughout the course of a whole season so your goalkeepers don't get bored of repetitive practice?
You have also people who make sessions to keep the goalies going. Mm-hmm. But for me, I'm very much in the way training in what happens in the game. Mm-hmm. So it can be that we do sometimes a session two times in 2 weeks because it's needed for this game. Yeah. But we have not a lot training, because if the games go to a week, then you have one or two sessions. So the number two and three then sometimes have on the day after the game a bit tougher session. Mm-hmm. And then obviously you have the day after already the game preparation. So I mix it up, but I'm very much thinking, if you working in the goal, you're learning your brain to think about what needs to happen, where do you have to be in positioning, how do you have to angle your feet, your body shape, your hands, and cutting angles to protect the goal as good as you can. So I'm pretty much, I would say, 80-90% work in the goal, and it can be different exercise with the same outcome. Mm-hmm. So that's how you think, you try to bring sometimes a new session, but bringing the same outcome.
Yeah, same outcome to ideas. So you touched on various techniques there from the goalkeeper. Yeah. What do you think has been the biggest change in what is required from the goalkeeper now as opposed to, let's say, 20, 30 years ago?
I think they have to be more a jumping athlete with having a quick reaction speed, quick in mind, quick decision making. They have to be able to do everything. If you play for Liverpool, you have to be able to distribute the ball well, make a good shot stopper, reading the game well, coming for crosses, be good in 1v1. So you know, and I know, there's not too many in the world like that.
They can do it all.
Yeah, so you have only a small market to look in, and that's what is needed. Social media is massive now, so they have to be mentally a lot stronger than in the past. In 20, 30 years was no Twitter where everyone tried to kill you, or everything is getting highlighted on Sky Sports with slow motion. If you do that 20 years ago, I'm pretty sure then all the goalkeepers also had a lot of issues.
Yeah. That actually brings me on to my next question. Obviously, as you mentioned, there's the Sky Sports and online social media. Mm. There has been some public criticism of Karius and Mignolet this season. What methods or techniques have you used with them in training to keep the morale high and confidence high?
Yeah, I mean, that is part from playing for Liverpool. If you look in the world, if you go on pre-season tour to China or whatever, you will see how big Liverpool is. You cannot imagine If you go to, say, Indonesia, the whole airport is red with all Liverpool shirts and completely mad. So then you have that problem, you know, people highlight things and they can find mistakes on any goalkeeper in the world. If you want to find them, you'll find them, you know. And but sometimes you have to accept it as well, you know, no one is perfect.
Yeah.
But we always stay calm with it, you know. You have to talk about it, but not let it take over, basically. And you have to focus on your job. You have to be professional and get on with it, you know. There's no one in the world makes no mistakes.
So do you go through video analysis with your goalkeepers?
Yeah, we show them videos. If there's anything to look at, you can look at anything, really.
Yeah.
But you always need to find the positive and not only the negative.
Yeah,
you
constructive.
Know,
yep.
Because the next game he has to perform again. So we always talk about it and move on. You know, that's how it is. So positive, but also not putting the mistakes away and try to improve them and talk about it. What can we do better or what could you do better? And that's how it works.
So that also leads me on to another question that we have from one of our followers, and he is asking, what advice would you give to create a strong bond between two goalkeepers that are battling for the number one jersey?
Yeah. We have actually three here,
yeah.
You know, because people forget Danny Ward.
Danny Ward, yeah.
He's the Wales number two.
He had a great season last year.
Yeah, he's a good goalie, and obviously Lloris is a really good goalie, and Sai as well. You know, everyone has different qualities. The whole Sai is also in the Belgium squad. So, I try to be the same to everyone. You know, the boys figure out who is the number one, two, and three. So who goes first in goal, they automatically do it.
Yeah.
There's no problem in there. They're all good guys. You give all individual talks about what can be better. If they had not a good day, you talk to them about it, or what could you improve next to on the field, in the gym, you know, body shape, everything, you know. So you talk individual to them, and I don't do any different to the number one than to the number three. In the training, I try to divide it also in the sessions, you know, the number two is one day in the session, the number three the other day. The number one sometimes comes out as well if I think he needs to do a bit more, I need more time to do a little bit work for the coming game. So it's no problem, and you need to respect all the three boys in the way they are and try to help them, each individual.
Is there any differences in how you prepare your goalkeeper for a Champions League match as opposed to a Premier League match?
It depends how the opponent plays, basically, you know.
So that's the only difference, just the opponent?
Yeah, you work from game to game, so
mm-hmm.
The only difference is while you're playing the one game, you're also thinking already for the next game.
Yeah.
So I already have in mind what I have to do for the next game, and now we have the meeting that probably will be backed up. You know, you have the experience from, you know, already roughly how teams play because you see them most of the time. So Champions League is exactly the same. We get the analysis, we get all the information. We have a meeting with the goalies on it as well to talk about what happens and what they have to think and show them. Free kicks, corners, whatever, to prepare them. So, there's not a specific difference between Champions League because you have to prepare the same. You have to make clean sheets to win games. So that's where you prepare for all the time.
So one last question from one of our followers. He is asking, is there any advice you would give to young goalkeepers who want to reach the top?
One thing is to invest a lot in yourself and improve everything, work on it every day, you know. I think that we could do a lot more training with goalkeepers. You know, if you look at a specific goalkeeper in the younger age, it's maybe 1 hour a week or 2 hours a week.
Yeah.
but it could be a lot more. If young gymnasts train 20 hours a week, why goalkeepers cannot do more?
Yeah,
you know, and that doesn't mean they have to be on the field every day to dive up and down, but they could do quick feet in the house, they could do jumping to improve the core stability, the speed, the strength, and all that stuff. And I think that is one of my points where and how we could make in the future better goalies.
Mm-hmm.
But there must be a change in mind, in my opinion, on this subject.
Mm-hmm.
And if people are not prepared to think like that, then we're still catching up all the time.
Yeah.
And I see that in Holland, and I see that in the UK, it's the same.
That's a great advice there, guys. So thank you very much, John. So before I do let you go, I just want to ask you some personal questions about your experiences. So we'll have a couple here.
Yeah.
What is the best stadium that you've either played or coached, and you're not allowed to say Anfield? You have to say something different.
We've been to a few clubs now with Liverpool. We've been in some amazing stadiums in the US, and you know, we've been Real Madrid, we've been, it's all the same for me. You focus just on the job, really.
The 18 yard box and the
yeah, right, and you need to prepare the goalie for what is coming, and
yeah,
and that is how I think more really than
So in a way, do you maybe not take the whole experience in because you're so focused on the job?
Maybe not. People always say, oh, you have a great job, and yeah, maybe that's the truth, but I don't see it like that.
Yeah.
It's my passion, and you know, you always want to do the best, and you focus on what you have to do, and yeah, you're always in your mind to focus on this game, and then the game is finished, then straight after I'm thinking the next one.
Yeah.
And that's how it works. But in my playing career, I had a few, you know, we had a lot of good games. We got to the Wembley final three times, to the quarterfinals of the FA Cup, so we beat a lot of Premier League teams. One was Everton 3-0 away, that was not bad. obviously we won 4-3 Southampton at home, where we were 3-0 down in half time, so they're all magic games to play in, you know, but that's all history, you know. I live in the now, so for myself it's just every game is a new challenge to win and keep a clean sheet.
So leading on to the next one, you maybe covered it slightly there, but what has been your most memorable experience as a player or a coach up to this point?
Yeah, you know, we got obviously to a few finals. That's always where you play for. You want to win things, so
yeah.
And that is still the aim here at Liverpool. We are on a good way, but we want to win something. So that is the plan for the coming times. So.
You hear coaches getting asked this question a lot, but I'm going to ask you, does it feel better achieving a success as a player, or is it better as a coach?
Yeah, player was nice, no? It was always also dealing with pressure, because as a goalie, you know, people always say to me, oh, you have to enjoy the game. You can only enjoy the game after the game when you won and you play well and the team won.
Yeah.
And there was no mistakes and you concede no goals. But it was hardly ever that you played the perfect game, you know. But I've had a good career, but this is the best you can do next to it, you know. Enjoy looking at the goalies, try to help them improve them, and hope they do well. That's how it is, you know. You win together and you lose together.
Yeah.
That's how it is as a coach as well.
Great. So one last question, Joe, before I let you go. I always like to ask this whenever I meet guys like yourself. Who is your goalkeeping idol and why?
When I was playing in Holland, we had Van Breukelen, who played for Nottingham Forest, and he was in the Dutch national team, and he was also passionate. And obviously, in my time with Neversout, I was a good goalie. I liked that style. But there's a lot of been a lot of good goalies over the years now. Mm-hmm. So when you play, you don't have that too much, you know.
Yeah.
You only think about, I want to be better than everyone. And that is your drive, you know, when you are a player, you want to be better than everyone to try and drive yourself on.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I always used to think when I play to the opponent. I always thought I have to be better than them.
Excellent. So thank you for joining me today, John. It's been an absolute pleasure.
Nice to talk to you. So
guys, there you go. That's the end of John Achterberg's interview. We hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see more goalkeeping related interviews, please click that subscribe button down at the bottom of the screen, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.